हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। दिस इज उदय पंडित एंड यू आर वाचिंग एमईपी टेक्निकल वर्ल्ड। सो इन दिस वीडियो विल लर्न अबाउट कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड वर्किंग ऑफ थर्मल ओवरलोड रिले। सो बिफोर स्टार्ट दिस सेशन, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू, इफ यू आर नॉट एट सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल, प्लीज सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड ऑल्सो हिट द बेल आइकन, सो यू विल गेट नोटिफिकेशन रिगार्डिंग माई अपकमिंग वीडियोज। Okay, so let's get started. So basically, what is thermal overload relay, or we can say OLR relay? So thermal overload relay is a protective device which is designed to cut the main power supply if the motor draws too much current due to the overload or phase failure for an extended period of the time. So basically, thermal overload relay is a protective device. So it is especially used to protect the motor. Okay, so this relay is actually used to protect the motor. At what condition? In case motor is operating at overloaded condition, or in case phase failure condition. Means among these three phase, if one phase is out, at that condition, if the motor is operating at two phase, it means it draws more current and winding temperature of the motor will be increased. Hence, at that condition, this relay will trip the incoming main power supply. So in this way, this thermal overload relay protect the motor. Okay, now let's discuss about its construction and how does it work. Okay, so construction and working of thermal overload relay. So here we have a three parts. Okay, one over here, this is the contactor part. Okay, and this one is thermal overload relay part. Okay, and finally this one is induction motor. Okay, so between induction motor and contactor we have a thermal overload relay. Main component of thermal overload relay is bimetallic strip. It is made up by two different material, we can say steel or brass. Okay, so this is the bimetallic strip. If we talk about property of bimetallic strip, when we apply the heat over on bimetallic strip, so at certain temperature, according to the material property, this strip will be bent. Okay, so this is the property of the bimetallic strip. And here we have also a spring arrangement, okay, of this contact. So this is the movable contact. Okay, and this one is common terminal, where we can connect the single phase power supply, which is 220 volt AC. Okay, here, and here we have a NC contact. This one is NC contact, which is normally closed contact. As you can see over here, this contact is actually connected with this terminal. That's why it is normally closed. Okay, and this contact is normally open because it is opened here, it is not connected with this movable contacts. That's why it is normally open contact of this thermal overload relay. Okay, and from here it is connected to the indicator terminal. Okay, LED indicator terminal. And from NC terminal it is connected to the contactor A1 terminal, which is coil supply actually, which is coil supply terminal of this contactor. And here neutral is directly given through this black wire to this indicator and to this contactor coil, which is at A2. Okay, so these are the parts of thermal overload relay. And here we have a terminals, which is like pin. pin terminal, okay, and it is inserted to the output terminal of this contactor. And from the output terminal of this thermal overload relay, we can connect the motor, okay. So this is the overview of this thermal overload relay. Now let's discuss basically how does it work. So initially our motor is running at normal condition. Suppose this motor is running at normal condition, okay, we don't have any fault like phase failure. Even this motor is not running at overloaded condition, okay. So this motor is running smoothly at right now, okay. So in this condition what happened, this bimetallic strip is straight, okay. So this is the straight, and now at this condition this contactor got the phase supply, or we can say live supply, through this NC contact, okay, in this way. Because it is normally closed, that's why it allows the power to flow through this contact. In this way this contactor will get a power. As you know that this contactor is already getting neutral from this side, hence contactor get energized. That's why this contactor allows the main power from input terminal to its output terminal, and finally it is given to the thermal overload relay, and then it is given to the motor. Hence this motor is operating at this condition, okay. So in this condition this indicator will be off, because our motor is running at normal condition. If this indicator is off, it means our motor is running at normal condition, okay, because here this is NO contact, so that's why this will not get a power at this condition. Now let's assume our motor is now operating or running at overloaded condition. Now at this condition what happened, motor circuit, or we can say motor winding, will draw the more current, which is more than rated current of this motor. So actually at this condition this motor circuit will draw the more current. Hence due to increase the current, it means winding temperature of this motor will also increase. So due to winding temperature this bimetallic strip will get bend like this, as you can see. Now at this condition what happened, this bended strip will push this movable contact from this NC contact to NO contact in this way, as you can see over here. Now at this condition A1 terminal of this contactor, which is coil supply terminal, will not get a power supply. So at right now this is not getting power supply because of NC contact become NO, as this strip pushes this movable contact towards this NO contact. That's why it breaks the circuit of this contactor. Hence this contactor will get de-energized. Hence this will break the main incoming power supply. So it will not allow the power to flow towards this thermal overload relay. So in this condition what happened, if the motor will be running at overloaded condition, then this bimetallic strip bends and it pushes this movable contact. Hence it breaks the circuit over here. Due to this contactor will not get a power. Hence this contactor will get de-energized. Hence this will break the main incoming power supply. Finally our motor will be stopped. So in this way this thermal overload relay protect this motor, okay. And in this condition also, now this indicator will get a power supply through this contact, because this NO contact now it is NC, as you can see over here. Now in this way this will get a power, hence this will glow. Actually if this indicator will glow, it means it is in trip condition. So basically it is for monitoring purpose. If the indicator is glowing, means our relay is at trip condition. We have a fault in our motor. We can observe from this indicator. Okay, so in this way, this thermal overload relay protect the motor. Okay, now let's move to the real view of this thermal overload relay. Actually, how does it look like? Okay, so here we have a thermal overload relay. So this is the real view of thermal overload relay. Okay, and this is made by Schneider Electric. Okay, so it has a 3 pins at input terminals. So this is L1, L2 and L3. So this part is inserted at output terminal of the contactor. Okay, and here we have a setting option. So this is the knob. With the help of this, we can set the overload current range according to the our motor rating. So with the help of a screwdriver, we can set it. So it has a range from 1.6 ampere to 2.5. okay, if we set the knob at 2.5, it means if the our motor will draw the 2.5 ampere current at that time, this relay will be tripped. So at that condition, our motor will be protected. Okay, and here we have a deep switch. As you can see over here, this is the deep switch where we have an option H and A. If we select the deep switch towards this H, it means we can reset this thermal overload relay with the help of this reset button by manually. Okay, so this is actually reset button. In case this relay is at trip condition, then if we want to reset this relay, if the fault is clear, then with the help of this reset button, we can reset this thermal overload relay. Okay, if we select this deep switch towards the A side, it means this thermal overload relay will be automatically reset itself. Okay, and this is the stop button, or we can say also test button. By manually we can trip this thermal load relay if we press this stop button. Okay, and we can also check the functionality of this thermal overload relay with the help of this button, which is a stop button. Okay, and this is the output terminal T1, T2, T3. Okay, here we can connect the motor at output terminal. Okay, and these are the contacts, controlling contacts, auxiliary contact we can say, of this thermal overload relay. 97 and 98, both are NO contact actually. Okay, and this 95 and 96, these are actually NC contacts. Okay, this contact will be changed after we have any fault in the motor. Okay, so this is the overview of thermal overload relay. And here we have another thermal overload relay, which is also made by Schneider Electric, but it is for higher capacity motor. Current setting range from 12 ampere to 18 ampere. Okay, otherwise everything is same. Here we have also reset button, stop. Here we have a deep switch, H and A. Here we have a NO contact, NC contact and terminals. Okay, so these are the thermal overload relays which have different current ratings. Okay, and this is the contactor. Okay, which is also made by Schneider Electric. So this is the input terminal where we can connect R, Y, B, and this is the output terminal where we can connect this thermal overload relay. We can insert these 3 pins into this terminal, and after inserting it, we can tight this terminal with the help of a screw. Actually, this thermal overload relay always comes with this contactor. It is always assembled together. Okay, so here this is the arrangement. Actually, how look like? This is the contactor with thermal overload relay. As I have told you, this relay, this is the contactor actually, and below it we have a thermal overload relay. So this relay always comes with this main contactor. Okay, here similarly we have a LNT made contactor. So this is the contactor part, and here below it we have a thermal overload relay which is made by LNT. So here we have also connected this pin. So in this fashion actually these two are arranged in our starter circuit. So this relay actually used in starter motor starter circuit, in DOL starter, direct online starter, which is and a reverse forward starter, a star delta starter, where we can use this thermal overload relay. Okay, so in this video we have learned about construction and working of thermal overload relay. So hope you guys understand about these topics. So thank you for watching this video. Please like, share, comments and subscribe, and also hit the bell icon so you'll get notification regarding my upcoming videos. So thank you very much. See you again in next video.